And you see people with packets, some containing 24 canisters of beer. Why? Because they say we've worked the whole week, we need to drink and rest. But they drink and don't find rest. Rather, the alcohol or the beer goes to work on their liver and on their kidney and deposit something that is detrimental to their health. In their mouth, it will taste rather sweet, but inside of their body, there is a chemical reaction going on. There is a corrosion going on the liver, on the kidney, in the lungs.
Yeah.
So you see, these elements that they think will bring them joy and peace and care and peace and joy, rather leave them with a hangover, a side effect that will require them to spend every dime that they have ever saved, that is granted that they have a saving, to try to get well. That is why we have to pay more heed to what Jesus is saying here. He said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes on him should not die, should not perish, but have everlasting life. When you put your trust in Jesus Christ, when you receive Jesus Christ into your life, eternal life, everlasting life is what you have. And it brings with it peace, joy, and rest. A kind of joy and a kind of rest and a kind of peace that will not cause you to go and see a doctor to remedy something that is all wrong in your body. Because those, the rest and the peace and the joy that Jesus Christ gives health to your liver, to your kidney, to your lungs, to your heart, to your brains, to your eyesight, to your hearing, to every part of your being. That is what Jesus Christ brings into your life. So then that brings me to the book of Ephesians, chapter 1. Remember, it says, blessed be the Lord God of the God of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. Jesus Christ, when it comes to live in your heart, he comes with all the blessings that heaven gives. Because Jesus Christ is God incarnate. And whatever Jesus Christ is, everything in heaven is. So can you imagine Jesus Christ living in your heart? It is just like the whole heaven has descended into your heart and into your home. He brings rest, he brings peace, he brings joy. That is why Jesus Christ said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. I will give you rest. That's what Jesus Christ said. I will give you what? Rest. He's the only one who gives rest. And the rest that Jesus Christ gives is a permanent rest. There will be chaos going on around you. That will not disturb the rest of them. How do I know that? There is a story told in the book, in the book of Matthew, where Jesus Christ was in a boat with his disciples. And the Bible said, suddenly there was a storm. Jesus was sound asleep. When the disciples were screaming, the boat was tossing back up and down. And they said, Jesus, do you care if we die? He was sound asleep. He is peace in the midst of a storm.
Yes.
Amen.
And when you receive him into your life, he brings that same peace into your life. So much so that in the midst of chaos, you have rest. And this is what Jesus Christ is offering unto all of us. City of Greensboro, County of Guilford, State of North Carolina, Nation of America, and the world at large. Jesus Christ wants to come and live in your life. He wants to give you rest. He wants to give you rest. He saying, you've been running helter-skelter for too long. You've been wandering from place to place looking for peace.
Yes.
You want to try this, you want to try that. Jesus says, stop trying. Jesus Christ is saying, stop trying. Come unto me. Come with all your laboring. Come with all your burden. Come with all the weights that you are carrying. And I am going to offload them. I will give you my rest. I will give you my yoke. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. City of Greensboro. Jesus Christ is offering us his peace tonight. But you know what the book of John is saying. He said, Jesus Christ, who is light, has come. But humans, we hate light. We want darkness. So today when you go into our streets, today is Friday night, and tomorrow night, you find in most of the places that they have parties, you have the line filled with everybody wants to go in there and party. And they do it at night. Even in the darkness, in the room where they go, they still turn the light off. They like double darkness. Humans love double darkness. They turn the lights off, saying they are having fun. And in the midst of those fun, it is punctuated with gunshots. There's never a day that they will go and have those that wild parties that will not be here, that there has been a couple, somebody is wounded, or somebody is dead. Humans love darkness. But Jesus Christ, as light, has come. And he's offering his light for free. It's free of charge. It's free of charge. Beloved, tonight, I want to enjoin our hearts to the fact that the salvation that Jesus Christ is offering to our city, our state, our nation, America, and the world at large is free of charge. So when you come to a crusade like this, as all nations, we don't take offering. Why? Because your soul is more important than that money.
Amen.
It is your soul. Jesus Christ wants to set you free from the darkness. He wants to give you rest tonight. My beloved, Jesus Christ wants to give you rest. He gives you rest. You've been moving from south to north, north to east, east to west. You've been wandering the whole earth looking for peace, looking for rest. You cannot find it anywhere but in Jesus Christ, the crucified, the Son of the living God, the only one who rose again from the dead.
Yes, hallelujah. Preach.
No, you cannot find rest in Muhammad. You cannot find rest in Buddha.
That's right.
You cannot find rest in Confucius. You cannot find rest in anybody. All those names that I've mentioned, they belong to religion. They establish religion. And that is all that there is, religion. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life.
Amen.
He's not religion. His life, Jesus Christ is life. He is the only one who, when he comes into your life, he transforms your life. He changes your life. We talked about Mother Teresa. We thank God for her. But she died, and her bones are still in the grave. We talk about Muhammad. He died. His bones are still in the grave. We talk about Abraham, he died. His bones are still in the grave. Moses, he died. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Buddha, he died. His bones are still in the grave.
Yeah.
There is only one person who rose from the dead.
Right.
His name is Jesus Christ.
Yes.
He's the only one who shed his blood.
Yeah.
All the others who are mentioned, none of them shed his blood. It's only Jesus Christ who shed his blood. And it is only Jesus whose blood washes away your sins and my sins. It is only Jesus whose blood heals all our diseases. It is only Jesus Christ. Bible says that the life of the soul is in the blood.
Yeah.
And the life of Jesus Christ is in his blood. It is the blood of Jesus Christ washing and making you whole that gives you eternal life. Tonight, City of Greensboro, County of Guilford, State of North Carolina, the nation of America and the world at large, Africa, Asia, Europe, South America, Middle and the Far East, Australia, Canada, Antarctica, and everywhere that humans are. If you are watching me today by way of YouTube, I want to let you know that there is only one person who can set your soul free. His name is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
His name is Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
He's the only one who can set you free. He's the only one whose blood can make you whole. Only Jesus. No other person. And his salvation is free of charge.
Yes.
It's free.
Yes.
It's free.
Yes.
It's free.
Hallelujah.
It's free.
Yeah.
It's free. It's free. It's free. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Oh, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Oh, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Oh, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Oh, hallelujah. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Yeah, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me free. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me. Hallelujah. Oh, the blood of Jesus sets me. Oh, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me. Hallelujah. Oh, the blood of Jesus sets me. Oh, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me. Yeah, hallelujah. Oh, the blood of Jesus sets me. The blood of Jesus. You have to be here. Don't be talking amongst yourself. We are in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Reverence the presence of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The book of Ephesians. Before we bring this message to a close, the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, I just quoted that chapter. Chapter 1, verse 3. It says, blessed be the Lord God, the God of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. When Jesus Christ comes to live in your heart, when Jesus Christ comes to live in your heart, he brings everything that is in heaven into your heart. That is what Paul is talking about. He has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places. My fellow people in Greensboro, in Guilford County, in the state of North Carolina, in America, you don't know what you are missing. When you reject Jesus Christ, you are missing a great thing. You are missing a great blessing. Because Jesus Christ in your life is just like the whole heaven indwelling you. Let me give you an illustration. When the ambassador of America goes to any other country, he represents, he brings the whole of America to that country. If for any reason somebody touches him in that country, let's say he is in Guatemala or in Mexico, And the Mexican government doesn't protect him. And somebody goes to shoot him, he's going to start a war. Why? Because they have attacked America in Mexico.
That's right.
If the president of America comes to your house to spend the night, for that one night, he brings the whole of America into your house. That is how it looks like. Hallelujah. But there is somebody far greater than the president of America, than the ambassador of America in any nation. His name is Jesus Christ. When he came to live in your home, he built the whole of heaven. That is why Paul is saying, blessed be the God of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. All spiritual blessings. I'm not talking about material blessings. I'm not talking about material things. Today, our churches are saturated with materialism. Our focus is more about material things. That is not the occupation of God. Jesus said this, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and leave the rest with me. He will supply.